Hello dear students, a very warm good morning all of you. So as we know, you are discussing with me a first lesson from the biology, that is the nutrition in plants. Okay, and among this nutrition in the plant, already we have discussed some points. Okay, so in that some point we have discussed about the autotrophic mode of nutrition and who follows or who is showing the autotrophic mode of nutrition. Yes, you are correct, green plants are there, those who are only showing the autotrophic mode of nutritions. Okay, so now let's move for the next mode of the nutrition, that is what? Heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so this is the another mode of the nutrition which are also shown by the some non-green plants. Okay, so what is meant by the heterotrophic mode of nutrition? The nutrition, or the in the nutrition where the animals are unable to mix their own food, for their own food that depends on other, and that mode of nutrition is called as what? Heterotrophic mode of nutritions. Okay, in that heterotrophic mode of nutrition, mainly the all human beings and animals are coming, and the plants, those who are non-green plants or the non-green plants are comes under this heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So human being, animals and all non-green plants are showing the mode of nutrition, that is nothing but what? Heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so this heterotrophic mode of nutrition is also having different types, or there are the different types of heterotrophic mode of nutrition, which are saprotrophic mode of nutrition, then parasitic is there, and symbiosis is also there. Okay, so these are the three types of the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, and this each type we are going to see deeply one by one. So today we will start with first, that is what? Saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so let's see what is meant by saprotrophic mode of nutrition, what exactly happens in that, and how is the organisms are getting the nutrients from this nutrition. Okay, so here we will discuss about the saprotrophic mode of nutrition. So this saprotrophic mode of nutrition is shown by the non-green plants. Okay, why I am telling non-green plants? Because as we know, the plants are green in color. Why? Because of the presence of chlorophyll. But very important thing, students, keep in your mind, that is what? The non-green plant means what? They doesn't contain the chlorophyll. That's why they cannot mix their own food with the help of the photosynthesis process. And that is the reason we are calling them as what? Non-green plants, because they doesn't have chlorophyll and they cannot mix their own food. So how they are getting their food? With the help of this saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so with the help of this saprotrophic mode of nutrition, they are making, or they are trying to get the nutrients. Basically, the plants, those who are not green, they are in a white in the color, or they doesn't have the leaves. Okay, so the plants, or the non-green plants, basically having the white color, and the very important thing, or the keyword I can say, that what? That non-green plant doesn't have the proper leaves. Okay, so let's see what is mean by exactly saprotrophic mode of nutrition. So here I have written the definition of the saprotrophic nutrition. Let's read it first, then we'll discuss. The mode of nutrition in which the non-green plant, very important word, what? Non-green plants obtain their nutrients from dead and decaying organic matter of plants and animals is called saprotrophic nutrition. Okay, so what is mean by the saprotrophic nutrition? It is the mode of nutrition, it is the type of the nutrition in which what happens, in which non-green plants, okay, in which what? Non-green plants obtain their nutrients from what? Obtain their nutrients from dead and decaying matter of who? Dead and decaying organic matter of what? Plants and animals. Okay, so see, sometime what happened, the animals get died, okay, or the plants, some leaves drop down, sometime the plants also get died, okay, and all these things are remaining in the soil. But after certain days, we can say that that certain plant or the certain animal body were not there. So where it goes? It get decomposed, it get decaying with the help of the certain types of the bacteria and the fungi. Okay, so that is the reason or we can say that is the only process which happens, that is nothing but what? Saprotrophy nutrition. Okay, from the dead and decaying matter, the organisms, the non-green plants are taking their nutrients. Okay, and that mode of the nutrition is called as what? Saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, once again I will repeat. The mode of nutrition in which the non-green plants obtain their nutrients from dead and decaying organic matter of plants and animals is called as what? Saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so let's see which animals or which organisms are following the saprotrophic mode of nutrition. The plants which use saprotrophic mode of nutrition are called saprophytes. Okay, very important word, student. Keep in your mind what? The organisms, those who are showing the mode of nutrition, which mode of nutrition? That is saprotrophic mode of nutrition. That organisms are called as what? Saprophytes. Okay, in our previous lectures, we have discussed that the organisms, those who are following the autotrophic mode of nutrition, for them we are calling as what? Autotrophs. Okay, those who are following the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, for them we are calling as what? Heterotrophs. Okay, for like that only, the organisms, those who are following the saprotrophic mode of nutrition, that organisms are called as what? Saprophytes. Okay, and the examples are, we can say that Indian pipe is there and coral root is there. Okay, so how they are taking? Basically, the non-green plants are having the fungi in their roots. Okay, the non-green plants like the Indian pipe and the coral root are having the fungi in their roots. Okay, and what this fungi is doing? This fungi is release the certain types of the organisms or certain type of the organic matter on the dead and decaying matter, and in that organic substance, the nutrients which are present in the dead and decaying matter get mixed into the organic liquid or the organic substance which are secreted by the fungi, and again that organisms are sucking that nutrients. Okay, the organisms are sucking that nutrients. Okay, so the fungi are secreted some digestive juices. Okay, or we can say that organic substances, the fungi secreted some digestive juices on the dead and decaying matter, and that digestive juice is secreted by the organism, is sucked by the organism as a nutrients. Okay, so in this way they are taking or they are fulfilled the need of their nutrients from the dead and decaying matter. Okay, once again I will repeat how they are taking. The fungi secreted the non-green plants are having the fungi in their root. That fungi secreted the digestive juice on the dead and decaying matter, and that digestive juice is get secreted by an organisms, and in this way they are fulfill their need of the nutrients. Okay, so in this way they are taking the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter. Okay, so which are the fungi? We can say that there are the saprophytes, like fungi and bacteria are known as saprophytes. So there are the different types of the fungi. We can say the fungi likes mold is there, mushroom is there, and is there. Okay, and also the some bacteria are also known as what? Saprotrophs. Okay, so earlier these fungi were considered as a plant, but due to the certain type of the special character or due to the certain types of the different characters from the plant, now the fungi is not part of a plant and it is considered as a separate group. Okay, or it is considered as a separate kingdom as a fungi. Okay, so the fungi is not a plant, it is a separate kingdom which is known as also what? Fungi. Okay, so here we have discussed about what? Saprotrophic mode of nutrition. The organisms, those who are following the saprotrophic mode of nutrition, are called as what? Saprophytes. Examples are Indian pipe and coral root. Also we can say there are fungi like mold, mushroom, bacteria. Okay, and yeast, which also comes in the fungi, all these are known as what? Saprotrophs. Okay, So how they are taking their food? The fungi secreted the digestive juice on the dead and decaying matter and converted into a liquid, and that liquid is get sucked by the organism and they are fulfill their need of the nutrition. Okay, so in this way today we have discussed about the first mode in the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, that is what? Saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so this is all about today. This is the time to tell you goodbye. I'll see you in the next video. For today, thank you.